Hey my friends, welcome back. Yeah, as you can see in today's video, we're gonna paint some nice little dreamy cloud scene. Yeah, you see the palette that I'm pre-mixing for the first layer of color. And we, like always, use the same seven base colors here. Like I always use for basically all of my paintings. I was using here a HDF plate, size 40 by 50 centimeters. And this liquid here is purified linseed oil that I'm using to kind of seal the surface to make sure the color is not really sucked in. And then I start to apply the colors, grabbing a fresh, soft flat brush. Starting basically with the brown color, as you can see, on the basement, on the area between the water and the sky, more or less. Applying the color, and then I'm grabbing a very soft brush without any color to it and start to blend the whole thing. And I also try to really level out the color very evenly, and I also try to kind of hide the white of the canvas or the HDF plate completely. That's basically a very simple process. You need to make sure that the color you apply is not too much thinned down. I use just a drop of linseed oil to give it a bit of a flow, but color really needs to be very thick to cover the white of the canvas. So really don't make the mistake and go too thin with the color. I think this is the biggest point here. Rather too thick than too thin. And you see, I'm building up colors. I'm getting darker, bluer. And when I applied those colors, I grab a very soft picker brush and start to fine blend the areas. Again, there's no color to this brush here. Really make sure you wipe out the brush every now and then to really make sure that the color you catch up does not interfere with the color on the brush and on the canvas. And then I'm recycling kind of the existing color and start to apply the base color for the water. See, is now the set of brushes that I use for the second layer. Again, using the same seven colors. I of course also let the background color dry for a couple of days. And it took quite a while to dry up. And then I start to apply the color, as you can see here. Very rough, establishing the location of the color spots before. Then I grab a fresh brush, very soft one, round, and start to kind of rub the color into the background color. And this process repeats itself a couple of times until I'm really achieving the effect that I want to have. As you can see here, I'm kind of using the background color also to, I'm just basically using one color for the this reddish color here to, by adding or by using the background color to kind of not having to mix 25 colors for this background color here. And the same goes for this part here. Now I'm applying the color and going back and getting thicker, grabbing another brush, starting to blend. So I'm heavily using, at least on those border areas, a lot of this blue color of the background that we applied before. In some areas I mix again the color from the background and basically pull some holes into this color to make it look even more realistic. And also really note that I'm really trying to be very fuzzy, very, very detailed, not repeating myself too often with the shape of the cloud itself. Very random, very, yeah, kind of, yeah, very, yeah. I try to be realistic with this way of application. And also, again, here in this scene again, I'm using again the background color, the blue color, quite a bit. Also extending those clouds, kind of letting it melt in some areas into the background, having extensions all over the place, little ones, really building up the whole thing by layering it and going back, adding some more color in some areas. And this cloud has a lot of different colors to it. And this is, I think, very important. We have this warm colors on the right side, coming in from the sunlight, and those basically very bluish colors that we have on the shadow areas. And you know, I'm adding some even lighter colors here and there. First, roughly, as you can see here, looks off, very rough. Then I'll go back and start to fine blend those areas. And again, I'm extending some areas of the clouds. Trying to get in this fluffiness of the edges of the clouds. A very important aspect, I think. People tend to paint clouds like they were cut out. And this is, it couldn't be more far from the truth, to be honest. You can also see here, on the upper edge here, this bit lighter one, the cloud body really starts to fade out. And this is just done by using the dry brush technique and starting to really apply a very thin layer of color. Not much thinned down, actually. Yeah, that's what I do here. You see, I'm also constantly readjusting the colors here and there. Adding some tiny bits of lamp black. Yeah. Testing again. Okay, now it's dark enough. And I kind of rub this brush over the dry surface and start to really get in those very kind of emerging parts of the clouds. That is only achieved the way I do it, more or less, is by using this dry brush technique that really is so much easier than trying to blend those colors in the first place. Basically, what I did in my early days was just trying to put in those colors side by side in one layer, but this way it's much, much, much easier. The same goes for this part here. Adding just, extending the main body of the cloud a bit more to the outside and then kind of letting it fade out. And this is done in a very quick way, in a very efficient way, and it looks much, much, much better than when you try to get in those cloud bodies in just one sitting. And we also repeat ourselves color-wise. We have some very light areas here, but also very brownish, very dark, kind of grayish, those bluish areas. And you see this whole area here is basically built up with the dry brush technique. And I'm just going back here and there and adding some more color to this whole thing. Whenever I feel the need to really kind of build up even more substance of the cloud body. The same goes for the clouds in the lower end here, you can see. A bit more bluish, more distant to the clouds that are more far away. And the cloud bodies that I put in here now contain a bit more of this brownish color. And again, really be careful with the amount of color you have on the brush. Rather go in too thin than too thick. Really carefully building up, layering it up here and there. And to really make sure that you don't overdo it. You see that this brownish cloud, yeah, is a bit, nearly a bit too strong, but really watch it, be carefully. And you know, I'm building up the reflection on the water part. And for this color, I'm using quite a bit of linseed oil to thin down the colors. And I'm also blending, I'm applying the color, building up those little waves in the reflections here, as you can see here, and start then to fine blend with a soft brush those hard edges. Again, a very easy and very kind of quick way of building up waves, reflections, in a very realistic way and a very quick way on top. But it takes quite a while. You have to really constantly adjust the colors and go back a few feet and constantly check what's going on the canvas. Do we need some more waves here and there? Some other colors, some more reflections here and there. I mean, water is obviously a reflective surface, and this needs to be put in. Therefore, we need to repeat those colors from the clouds in the water itself. Therefore, I am showing it to you in a time lapse, because it took nearly forever. Repeating the colors of the sky. And here and there, this is really, I think, the key to natural, realistic looking reflections. That you basically mirror the cloud bodies on the water itself. Adding on top of that, of course, those wave bodies that you have here. And you need really to make sure that those parts are really, really put in very, in some areas very soft, blended. Very important, I think. I'm using a very flat brush to add even more of those distant reflections. Yeah, that's the finished painting. So, that's about it for today. I hope you liked this little video here, and don't forget to like, share and subscribe, and see you next time. Bye.